First of all, how good are you at Madden?
I don't play Madden much more than 2K. Guys.
Okay, because I was wondering, when you're using a joystick in the backfield, spinning around, how do you keep an eye on where your receivers are? Shoot a number of plays where you're spinning and then you find someone.
I mean, they do a great job of getting open, and I just got to keep my eyes downfield and I'll find them. So, I mean, it's the receivers, though. They do a great job of getting open.
Dan in the front row on your right.
Eric, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Thanks for asking. 35 yards in the first half. Second half, you end with 186, 221 overall. What can you say about Brizzly and Steve and how much they helped you out in some of those looks that you had in the third and fourth quarter?
Oh, I can't say enough about them. They're both great guys. It all started with the linemen up front, though. I mean, they're giving me time, and I mean, without time, I can't really do anything. So, I mean, it starts with the guys up front. But, I mean, Brizzly, he's fast, and he's a playmaker. And Steve, he's an athlete. He loves it. He loves football. He loves just, you know, trying to do the best he can for us. So it means a lot.
Nico, all the way in the back after right
here. I just wanted to ask, you know, in that third quarter, you guys are down to kind of ask Coach and Steve this already, but, you know, what's going through your mind and what was it that, you know, went through your mind that made you guys rally and come back to win going away?
I was just trying to have a level head. But the guys, they do a great job of, you know, keeping me up, you know, you got this, so it's nice to have them, you know, picking me up. But I always just try to keep a level head, try to keep my composure, do the best I can. Coach Lester, Coach Furco, they're all talking to me, so they're really helping me out. And Coach Lester telling me what he sees, other quarterbacks, you know, Austin, Zach, they tell me what they're seeing, so it really helps out.
Mark, all the way back.
Eric, back here. How are you? Last year, at this time, you're celebrating a big win over Oregon City.
Yeah.
Now you just beat Wake Forest in your college degree. You know, you seem like a stoic guy, but how does this feel to you?
It feels good. It's kind of surreal, but I'm just blessed to be here. And I'm so happy I chose Syracuse because I'm loving it here.
Any other questions for Eric? Joe.
Hey, Eric. Joe Maginell. On the big play with Brizzly. Obviously, you get the, you know, break around, the edge is coming at you. When did you know you were going to try downfield? Because that was the first big downfield throw that you made today.
Yeah, I mean, I just try to keep my eyes downfield when you're scrambling. I've always been taught that because that's where big plays happen. I just try to, you know, make sure it's not going to get picked off or anything. So, but Brizzy did a great job. He made a great play. So all credit goes to Brizzy.
Time for two more questions. We'll go to Mark.
Eric, again, in the red zone, you guys were 3-for-3, but all three were field goals. As a quarterback, how frustrating is that for you, and what do you want to do to change it?
I mean, it's frustrating. I mean, I'm a perfectionist. I want to go out there and score every time, so it's really frustrating. But, I mean, our field goal kicker did a great job of getting it in there. So, I mean, at the end of the day, as long as you're putting points up on the board, everything's going to be all right.